Jason, and it's Chad Pennington, your guest DJ on a Friday today. Chad feverishly signing away. How many times do you think, by the way, you've signed your name in your lifetime?
Oh, man, I don't know, but I'm in shape. I can handle it.
Yeah, you've done it so many times, you pretty much have never got a misspelling or anything like that.
No, you just the one thing I did learn, I had a chance to sign autographs with Joe Namath one time, and I was a little sloppy, and he just looked at me with a serious face, and he's like, son, if you're going to sign your autograph, they need to be able to read it. I said, yes, sir, whatever you want, Jack.
Take me on your trip to Miami. How exciting was that? You went to the Miami Dolphins, and, I mean, they welcomed you, not necessarily as a team, but, I mean, as far as the fans are concerned, they welcomed you with open arms.
Well, it was a smooth transition. It really was, especially it could have easily been an awkward transition, an awkward thing to do, but to have great teammates like I do and a great organization to help me through that process was unbelievable. And, I mean, just paint the picture. You're sitting in Cleveland for your first preseason game, and you get a knock on your door at 11:30 at night. And the security guy comes in and says, hey, Coach Mangini wants to talk to you. And I said, well, Steve, I can promise you this. He doesn't want to talk about the game plan.
Right.
So, and then, you know, 3 days later, there I am sitting at the Miami-Tampa Bay preseason game, and I'm a Miami Dolphin and brand-new teammates. And, you know, my wife's pregnant. She's scrambling around trying to sell her house and do all these things. So it was a little bit tough, but at the same time, it was very rewarding.
It's kind of like that feeling, I guess, of a training camp when they come knock on the door type deal.
It was.
You were in
camp.
Absolutely. Yeah.
That's exactly what it was like, and I'd never experienced that before. And, you know, I'd heard the talk about Brett coming in and possibly being a Jet, so I'd prepared myself for it. But at the same time, it was a little surreal.
So before we talk more about with the foundation and all that, I got to talk football on one thing. How is it having Parcells down there with you again?
Well, he's like a proud grandpa walking around. And I tell you one thing, you won't see him around when you're losing. But when you're winning, you'll see him at breakfast, and he'll be giving you little, you know, bits and pieces of info. But it's a lot of fun because he's one of the guys that when you're one of his guys, he takes care of you. And he wants to make sure that you're being taken care of. And as long as you're putting forth the effort and being a professional, he's going to treat you that way.
Wife get a little irritated sometimes when you take the wife and kids out for a talk. Taco Bell, and you spend the entire time that she wants to talk to you at the restaurant signing autographs and meeting and greeting people?
Well,
is it difficult to go to the grocery store and things like that?
It's not difficult, but you know what? When I was in New York, I enjoyed it because you live under such a microscope and you get scrutinized and you hear so much negativity. When you're out and about on the streets and you listen to somebody and they're coming up to you and they actually appreciate what you do, it's a little refreshing. It really is, because you can really get caught up in the negativity that's written and talked about you. And so to be able to talk to fans that appreciate what you do, it's nice.
Chad Pennington is here, your guest DJ on Magic 97.9. More coming up.